Good evening, everyone. First slide, please. This is a four-year-old girl who saw me early this month with a lesion in the left thigh. You see the lesion extending from the hip down to the knee. The lesion consists of papules which are arranged in a straight line. And this is in a four-year-old girl and in a straight line, papules, lesions were asymptomatic, making it a straightforward diagnosis of lichen striatus. And the pediatricians among the audience will be very familiar with this condition. Now, what is lichen striatus? Lichen striatus is a self-limiting condition of uncertain etiology. Both genetic and the environmental factors are known to be playing a part in lichen striatus. Lesions are papules which are arranged in a straight line, usually seen in the lower limbs, sometimes in the upper limbs as well. Larvae, the trunk is also involved. Lesions can affect the nails, causing onychodystrophy. Lesions are seen along the lines of Blaschko and are more commonly seen in atopics. Now, what are lines of Blaschko? In the year 1901, Blaschko delineated a number of congenital and acquired skin conditions in a doll. And these lines are called as Blaschko's lines. They do not correspond to either nerves or blood vessels, but are delineating the roots taken during cutaneous embryogenesis. Conditions like lichen striatus, as we see in this patient, nevus unius lateralis and incontinentia pigmenti follow Blaschko's lines over 120 years, and we still follow Blaschko's lines. Now, what is the management of this condition? It's a self-limiting condition, so generally reassurance is all that is needed. But the parents are not too happy when we say that, hold on, it will go. It goes off in 6 to 12 months. And some children have a little itching as well. So we give either topical steroids or topical calcineurin inhibitors like pimecrolimus or tacrolimus. And lesions usually resolve with no scars. And next slide will show the same lichen striatus in an older girl. She's about 7 years. And here we can see the lesions are on the upper limb, extending from the shoulder down to the wrist, and these are a little broader. Thank you very much.
You said it doesn't leave a scar, but will this produce a scar? The later slide, this one?
May not. It may not leave a scar. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If you are sure the lesions will go away on this wall, why do you yield to the pressure of the patient and prescribe a steroid ointment?
Sir, if I don't prescribe, they go to the next doctor.
No, that's not an excuse.
I know it is not, sir. I know it is not, sir. But this is what happens. And so rather than somebody putting a steroid, I'm going to put a tacrolimus or pimecrolimus, which is not going to cause any further damage to the skin.
Still, I think it's overkill, sir. I would say that, you know, prescribe a glycerin or something, you know, some moisturizer or something.
No, it's not helping, sir.
Any illness will become better with steroid. Any illness, whether it's a fever or asthma or anything, some sort of anti-inflammatory action is there.
But whether the relief is going to be worse than a disease of depression, sir. It all is unknown, madam. It's I, yeah. Thank you.
So now I request Dr. Eddy Larson, the first question, to hand over a certificate of appreciation to Dr. B. Srinivas. We want to